Hello and welcome to the 41st video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how you can animate a mask in After Effects. In the previous episode, we continued with the second section where we introduced the type and shape elements and animated the type in like so. In this video, we are going to complete the sequence and focus on the shape elements that also animate in this composition. Next, we are going to look at how we can animate a mask so these bar graphics in the middle appear to draw in from the outside like so. So in this video, we are going to be covering the following topics: applying a mask to a shape layer and animating a mask. So here I am where we left off in the previous episode, where we brought in the type and shape elements and animated the type. Now, if you're watching for the first time and wish to follow along, you can find this document in the project folder, which you can download. Link is in the description. The download folder comes with lots of exercise documents we will be using on this course that have been carefully developed to aid your learning experience. The folder also comes with document resources such as videos, graphics, and images you can use to build your first video presentation from scratch later on in this course. To get the full learning experience, I recommend you get the project folder. Download link with instructions is in the description. So with the project folder open, click into folder S3, Create a Project, then into folder 41, Animate a Mask, and open the Animate a Mask document. Now, if you are continuing on from the last episode, make sure you have your document open ready. So with our document open, let's proceed. So what we're going to do next is look at how we can animate the lines in between the two type layers to make them look like they draw in from the outside. So in this instance, to create this effect, I'm going to use a simple mask, and I'm going to start with the bar line on the left-hand side. So before I begin, I'll zoom in here so I can see exactly what we are working on. Now this bar line is a simple shape layer, which we created in the previous episode. And we know it's a shape layer because of the star icon next to the layer name. Now, there is a specific way to create masks on a shape layer. So down in the timeline panel, I'm going to drag my time indicator while holding shift over to snap to the beginning of my bar layers. And then I'll select the top bar layer. With the layer selected, we will now see a bounding box around it in the composition panel. Now, I'll come into the timeline panel and toggle down the layer properties to reveal the contents and transform properties. With the layer still selected, I'll come up to the top of the interface and click Layer. Upon click, I'll scroll down and place my mouse on Mask, then scroll across and click on New Mask. Upon click, we will now see a mask property become available in the layer properties. This has now applied a new mask to our shape layer, but right now nothing has changed. So I'll press F2 to deselect the layer, and next I'll come down and toggle down this new mask property. Inside, we will see a new property called Mask 1. Now, if we look closely to the right of Mask 1, we will see a drop-down box with the word Add inside. Now if we click this and select Subtract, notice the line graphic now disappears. By clicking Subtract, we have inverted the mask, so now it's hiding the shape layer. By setting this to either Add or Subtract, we can toggle the mask option. Though for now, I'll just click this and set it back to Add. Now if we toggle down Mask 1, we will see the mask properties, and here we have Mask Path, Mask Feather, Mask Opacity, and Mask Expansion. Here we can also see there is a stopwatch on each property which suggests we can animate them, which is exactly what we are going to do next. Now at this point, it's important to note that when we create a mask like this for a shape layer, the mask will fit exactly to the size of the shape. When we select this mask property on the layer, we will see a bounding box in the composition panel. This is actually the mask path and not the shape layer selected. Now let's look at animating this mask. So we want the line to appear as if it's drawing in from left to right. So with my time indicator right at the start of the layer bar, I'll come and click on the stopwatch for mask path and add my first position keyframe. Next, I'll drag my time indicator over to 3 seconds, then come back down and click on the diamond shape to add the second keyframe for the mask path. So now I'll drag my time indicator back to the first keyframe while holding shift to snap. And now I'll press and hold shift on the keyboard and press the left arrow. And as we do this, we will move the mask to the left and away from the line shape. When the mask is fully off the shape, the line will now appear invisible. So I'll press Alt/ to fit my screen area to the composition panel, and I'll scrub my time indicator from the first keyframe to the second, and now we can see the sequence. So next, I'll drag my time indicator over to the second keyframe, I'll select the two layers above, the swan shape layer and the type layer, and I'll drag them back left while holding Shift to snap the beginning of the layers to the time indicator. So now, the line appears to animate in from the left. And when it's full, the swan image and the type layer below appear right on cue. So that's the first bar done. To finish the sequence, I'm now going to create a mask and animate on the next bar. So now we have the timing of the first bar, this is going to make it super easy. So with the top bar layer selected, I'll press U to collapse the properties and just show the keyframes. Next, I'll select the right bar layer above, and like earlier, I'll come and toggle down the properties to reveal content and transform. With the layer still selected, I'll come up to the top of the interface and click Layer. Upon click, I'll scroll down and place my mouse on Mask, then scroll across and click on New Mask. Upon click, we will now see a new mask property become available in the layer properties. So I'll toggle this down until I can see the properties for the mask. And I'll drag my time indicator while holding Shift over to the first position keyframe for the mask above so it snaps on top. Next, I'll come and click on the stopwatch for mask path to add my first keyframe. Then I'll drag my time indicator over to the second keyframe while holding Shift to snap. And I'll come down and click on the diamond shape to add the second keyframe. Next, I'll drag the time indicator back to the first keyframe while holding Shift to snap. And with the mask property selected, I'll hold Shift on the keyboard and press the right arrow until the mask is away from the shape layer below. So I'll press F2 to deselect my layers and I'll scrub my time indicator over the keyframes to see the effect that has had. And now the two lines draw in from either side. Perfect! So I'll place my mouse cursor over the workspace area and double click. This will extend the work area to the entire comp timeline. I'll drag my time indicator over to the beginning of the timeline and I'll press spacebar to activate preview. And that completes the second section of the video presentation. First, we have the destination icon appear, then after it drops away, the type and shape elements animate on while the video transitions in the background. Perfect! So now the second section is complete, we can now move on to the next sections. Now if we click back into the main comp, and we can do this by clicking on the first tab on the top left of the timeline panel, we can see we still have another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sections to create. Now, if you've been following along with this, I recommend you save your document so we can continue on in the next episode. Now, it may seem like a lot of work to create the next 5 sections, but in this instance, it's going to be fairly easy. The next 4 sections are going to follow the same formula we just created for section 2. So a really easy way to speed up our workflow is to simply duplicate the composition and make subtle changes. So in the next video, I'm going to demonstrate how easy it can be to duplicate compositions and replace all the media elements to speed up the creative process. In the next video, we are going to create sections 3, 4, 5, and 6, which is going to progress us along nicely, which will take us almost up to the end of the video presentation. So see you in the next video.